Yo, what's up guys, it's your boy Mr. Ghana Baby once again. I'm just gonna continue the video that I did, and this video is just because of some requests from Black Americans. Like, I had few subscribers from America recently. That's why like I'm doing this video. They were like, we want to move to China, but we want to know whether China is safe for us. Okay, so I have Charles here. You've seen in most of my videos. And before I continue this video, let me give a shout out to George China Nonstop. He's also a YouTuber in China. He's doing great videos. And if you're really interested in Chinese videos or videos happening in China by expats in China, just go to China Nonstop, subscribe to his channel. It's a good friend of mine. Just go and subscribe to his channel, and I know you'll never get disappointed. Okay, so Charles, before we continue this video, like, people are asking me whether China is safe for Black people, you know, like, I know African Americans who want to move to China. So would you advise African Americans to move to China?
Yes, absolutely. But there is going to be an adjustment period. Because back in America, people are very politically correct. They're very censored in how they express their opinions about race.
Okay.
And here in China, it's completely different. It's like 180 degrees, the opposite. So you have to kind of realize that even though a Chinese person might say something that might be kind of, I guess, offensive by American standards, like, they don't mean any harm or hatred. They don't harbor any. I think the majority of people, let's say like 90%, are just like very welcoming, extremely hospitable. You know about
Chinese
extremely
people.
Nice.
Yeah.
Too nice, suspiciously nice. Like, they want something from you.
Like, he said when they want something from you, they are super nice and super friendly.
But even if you don't want anything.
It's good that you said the truth. When they want something from you, they're going to be super nice, okay?
Yeah.
So today's video, we want to tell you guys why African Americans should move to China. You know, first of all, I'm not African American. I'm from Africa, but I'm not African American. But I think this place is really a good opportunity for you guys to come and make a lot of money and go back to wherever you want to go to. So you've been here. You have anything that you want to tell them, like, why they should move to China? You know, because we see on TV, like, police people are shooting Black people in the street.
Yeah.
And does that happen in China?
No. Today, I was walking down the street, and a security guard looked at me and he said hello. And that happens like every, you know, 2 weeks or something.
Yeah,
they say hello. Like, in America, usually they stare, they give you a stare down, like, what are you doing here?
Yeah, because police officers in China are really friendly. Like, sometimes they see me and they want to talk to you, especially when you speak Chinese. They really want to talk to you because they don't care whether you're Black or white or something.
Yeah.
It's only one police who has been like kind of like, you know, very rude to me. I showed to him that no, you cannot be rude to me because I have a lot of police. I even showed him pictures of me and police people. The guy was telling my landlord, like, why are you renting your house to a Black man?
Oh, that guy.
That guy. Then I told him, hey, you cannot tell me that, because he thought I can't speak Chinese, you know.
Yeah.
Apart from police people, what about, do you have anything like why they should move to China?
The cliche is that, you know, to expand your horizon, which is true. I think you need to, it's good to kind of escape from the bubble, so to speak, of just living in America, because the world is not America.
Yeah.
And it's good to kind of be able to see, meet people from halfway across the world, and, you know, learn the language, learn the culture. And it is extremely rewarding. It is extremely stimulating when you're able to communicate even at the most basic level, but somebody from across the world.
And also, I have noticed that Chinese people are trying to learn the African-American culture, you know, like most Chinese people in here are learning that, like, the basketball, now they have, you have NBA, but now we have CBA in China.
CBA.
And a lot of, like, retired basketball players who are moving to China, and they are worshiping them. Let me put it this way: they are worshiping them. There's the guy in Beijing.
Yeah.
He's just like a king.
Yeah.
You know. So like, maybe if you know how to play basketball and you don't know what to do with your life, maybe my brother, maybe China is the best place for you.
Yeah,
you know?
you can make a couple $1 million.
A lot, because Chinese people, and also I've seen like Chinese people trying to learn like African American music, like the rap. Yeah, like I saw one song, Renminbi.
they all make black people sing.
You know, I have a black guy, yeah, but he's not from Africa. He's not African American. He's African, but he teaches Chinese people how to rap. You know,
yeah,
and he makes money. So maybe if you know how to, you know, how to write lyrics or something like that, if you can move to China, you can help the China music industry to move forward.
Yeah.
You know, that's also a way to...
Or just start like a basketball camp.
Good. That's it. That's what I'm saying.
Get a bunch of people to sign up and, you know,
it's just to them.
A lot
of people are doing that. Yeah. Because I know a lot of African-Americans who are teaching basketball. That's and they're making... And it's American football. You know, there are some training centers in China who are learning this American football. And also, they are making a lot of money. Like, I know one guy is making a lot of money. Yeah. And he told me that he's not ready to go back to America. Because back in America, he was not. Yeah.
I know, the women are better here. Easier money. Pay less taxes.
It looks as if Charles loves the women a lot. Eh? And what about tax? What about the tax? You know, what about the tax?
It's low here. It's like 10%, 10 to 15%.
And what about America compared?
America, usually like around 25-30%.
So
it's generally lower here, much lower here in China. So, and of course, cost of living is like really low. Besides the housing, in Beijing, housing is kind of expensive.
But
compared to American standards, it's like still cheaper than America, but like,
wow.
Overall, the cost of living is like, maybe half.
The cost of living in China is really, really cheap. Like, it's very low because even in Ghana, compared to Ghana, the cost of living in China is better than Ghana.
Yeah.
You know, because like, especially foodstuffs, I don't spend a lot on foodstuffs, you know.
Yeah.
Like, so in Ghana, I spend a lot on foodstuffs more than in China. So
if you want to come to a kind of stable society. I think China is very safe. It's very safe.
China is really safe. Like, talking about safety, you go to club at night. But please, like, sometimes nightlife in China is really risky.
Like anywhere.
But I also advise my black folks that if you go out there, like, please be safe. Please be safe because in China...
It just takes one bad guy.
Because I've seen people getting into trouble. Like, they were not at fault, but they went into trouble, you know. So try to be safe when you're out there at night trying to chill a bit. So I think these are a few reasons why I think black folks, like black Americans, who move to China, because Chinese people are trying to learn the black American culture. So if you have this talent that I've mentioned, you can come to China to teach English as a black American. You can come to China to teach basketball, American football, and also like a lot of things, you know.
Some side jobs.
A lot of things. So we hope you enjoyed this video. And please, like I said, don't forget to share this video to anyone who wants to move to China.
Don't be scared.
Just decide. If you think that you're making low income in America, my brother, China is the best
place for you. Even if you're making a good income.
China.
Come here for a year. Come here for a few months or whatever.
Just go away from home. It's good. Like, life in here is pretty good.
Yeah.
Life in here is pretty good. So it's Wadamaya again, and I'm gonna see you in my next video. Please don't forget to like this video. Don't forget to share, and please don't forget to subscribe.